Kuriakose Elias Chavara was born in 1805 as the sixth child of his devout Catholic parents at Kainagiri in Kuttanad in the state of Kerala. After his primary education, Kuriakose joined the seminary at Pallipuram in 1818. Though during his seminary days, he lost his parents and only brother to an epidemic, he continued his priestly studies and was ordained a priest on 29th November 1829. Along with his priestly duties, Father Kuriakose, who had exceptional creative and leadership qualities, could render great service for the spiritual progress of the church and to the socio-cultural development of Kerala, which at that time was very much backward on many levels. He identified that all forms of discrimination are the result of ignorance, which can be wiped out by education that will bring social change, mobility and development. There is no area of human endeavor where the fingers of St. Kuriakose Chavara have not touched. There are many firsts in the history of Kerala Church to his credit. As an educational visionary and social reformer of his time, he founded the first indigenous religious congregation for men known as Carmelites of Mary Immaculate, CMI, in 1831 at Mannanam, with a vision to serve the marginalized and underprivileged. In 1846, he opened a Sanskrit school. Chavara was the first to edit and publish the East Syrian Breviary. He prepared the first liturgical calendar in the Malabar Church in 1862. Convinced that the print media was a powerful medium to further learning, he began a Catholic printing press. The printing of the first prayer books in Malayalam and Deepika, the oldest Malayalam newspaper now in circulation, were started from this press. He encouraged opening schools adjoined to every parish church known as Pallikuram, boarding school attached to convents, and he co-founded the first native congregation for women known as Congregation of Mother of Carmel, CMC, at Kunammav, with a vision of Christian formation, education and empowerment of women. He was well aware that the stability and sanctity of families depended mostly on well-groomed women in society, and that investment in women's education would provide better fruits in the life of the individual, family and society at large. Chavara's educational reforms and contributions to society brought a new dawn in the history of Kerala. For people who had been denied education, he turned to be an educator. For all who were deprived of books, he became an apostle of printing technology and an author, writing a number of books in prose as well as in verse with a unique spiritual vision. To those who were denied of knowledge, he became disseminator of knowledge. To those who were caught in the grip of old traditions, he became a herald of social transformation. In 1987, the government of India released postal stamps in his honor for his humanitarian services to the country. St. Chavara's personal life inspires the educators and students of all times to imbibe an indomitable spirit and work towards education and formation of children, parent-teacher participation and educational leadership. Owing to his deep spirituality that permeated all his actions, Chavara was referred to as a man of God from his early years. He died on 3rd January 1871. And along with Sister Euphrasia Iluvathinkal, CMC, he was canonized by Pope Francis on 23rd November 2014. His mortal remains is kept in the chapel of St. Joseph's Monastery, Mannanam. St. Kuriakose Elias Chavara was a person who could live in harmony with God and the world, prayer and action, solitude and companionship. Many could say of him a man of eminent sanctity who practiced all the virtues. He had a word for everyone. To the children he said, "Children, you are God's investment in the hands of your parents." To parents he said, "Remember that it is your primary duty and responsibility to bring up your children." To the youth he said, "Do not be the cause of your parents shedding tears on account of you." To all he says, "Regular reading of good books and meditating on it will illumine the mind." May St. Kuriakose Chavara's dream of a society where all people can live in the joy of the children of God, enjoying equality, freedom, and prosperity come true.